What's up guys, welcome to Champion Champion. मैं हूं आपका दोस्त अनूप कामत. Today we are going to make another Konkani dish and we are at my mother's place. The name of the dish is patrode or patroda. Patrode is made with arbi leaves, that is colocasia leaves. In Asia it is also called as taro leaves. In Hawaii it's called karo leaves. This is an old crop and we have records suggesting that it was cultivated about 11,000 years back. Taro is hugely popular in Asia and also in Africa. It is also used in places like Greece and Turkey and in the Americas. Normally the corm or the root part of it, which is under the ground, is used, the arbi. But today's dish, we are going to make it with the leaves, the green leaves of colocasia. We are going to use the tender leaves of colocasia, make some rice paste, and then going to make taro pinwheels and then steam it. It's an extremely tasty dish, slightly spicy, and it is one of my favorites. This patrode can be eaten hot when it comes out of the steamer. You can slice it and eat it. You can also eat it after frying, or you can make a sabji out of it, or you can put it in a curry. You can make a patrode gashi with it and you can have it with rice. So this is a versatile dish and a tasty one. So let's see how patrode is made. The ingredients we require for patrode are this chopped fresh coconut, red chilies, few of them, dry red chilies, hing. Don't take the powdered hing, you can take the hing which is in pieces, solid pieces, turmeric powder, salt and some tamarind pulp. And also we require some rice. This is idli rice which has been soaked in water for some time and we have drained the water. Now all these ingredients we are going to grind and make it into a paste. This is how the paste looks like. This paste is very similar to the paste, the rice paste which we made for the moringa leaf. So these are the arbi leaves. These are quite tender leaves. You shouldn't take very old or thick leaves because these leaves contain oxalate crystals and after eating it your throat will start itching. So you have to take tender leaves, not very tender, this medium sized tender leaves. The first thing you have to do is that you have to remove these veins. You can see these thick veins, we have to remove it. So let's see how my mother does it. Amma just showed us how to remove the veins of the taro leaves. Actually, she has removed the veins of a bunch of leaves and she had stocked it in the fridge. There's no harm in doing it because this takes some time and care. So on the lower side of the leaf, she's applying some paste. This is the rice paste with the coconut and red chili, hing and haldi, and of course tamarind water. So you apply a thick layer or a thick coat of this rice paste on the lower side of the leaf. Now you keep another leaf on top of this and repeat the process. Again apply this rice paste. So my mother is stacking up these leaves one on top of each other, applying this rice paste with tamarind and all of the ingredients. We have to do this till we get a stack of about 10 to 12 leaves. So after that, when we roll these leaves, you get a nice thick roll. Thank you. It doesn't matter if the leaves are slightly torn, but what we have to do is you keep the largest leaf right at the bottom and then take smaller leaves on the top. It is very difficult to get uniform size leaves in Delhi, so we make do with the leaves we get here. Now she is going to make it into a nice roll. See the way she is going to roll. She is applying the rice paste on the folded sides also. The leaf should be completely covered with this paste. So she has folded it nicely. Now she is rolling from one edge. You keep on applying this rice paste. You can see how beautiful this roll is. You have to smear this paste all over the roll. You can also tie this roll with a string so that it doesn't unfold. It's a simple process, but a lot of prep time. Now we are going to transfer this roll into a steamer. Here it is. This is a normal idli steamer. My mother has kept a steel plate. So you can keep several rolls. You can keep maybe three rolls in this. So she is going to make another roll. So Amma says two rolls are enough. She has kept it in the steamer. We'll close the lid and steam it for some time. Now this is hot patrodi. It has been steaming for a while and it is ready. So we will let it cool for some time and we'll taste it. But meanwhile, just see how beautiful it looks. So we have one roll of patrode which has cooled down. It was actually piping hot, you saw that. So now we will have to just cut it into slices. When you cut it into slices, it will be like Swiss rolls. I'll just show you how it looks. You can see layers of leaves and the rice paste which has been cooked perfectly. So this is yellow and golden in color. Completely beautiful, just see. It is very flaky and if you move it like this, you can see how many layers it is. Just see this. So the patroda is sliced, beautiful Swiss roll like slices. You can see the layers of arbi patta with the rice paste which is perfectly cooked. Along with this patroda, I'm going to use little bit of coconut oil or you can use any oil. So I'm going to take a piece of patroda, dip it in this oil and I'm going to taste it. Just see this beautiful piece of patroda. So this piece of patroda, I'm going to dunk it in coconut oil. I'm going to make it slightly moist. I'm going to take a bite. That is a really good patroda. The patroda has got the correct combination of spices and heat. It's not too spicy and it's not too tangy or sour. The right amount of tamarind and chilies have gone with the coconut into this rice mixture and it has been cooked perfectly. Amma normally makes about 6-7 rolls at a time. It takes a lot of time and effort. But this is really super tasty. Once you steam it, you can keep them in the refrigerator for few days. What I really like to do with this patroda is that to take this patroda out, make them into slices and just fry them with little bit of oil. It will give a crispy dark brown edge to this patroda and inside will be still soft. I like to eat it with little bit of oil or with little bit of rice and dal. Or you can make a gashi with patrode. That recipe we will show in another episode. During rainy season, patroda or arbi leaves are plenty. So this is the season to make patroda. I strongly recommend that you try making it, though it takes a little bit of time. Your effort will be worth its time. For more such recipes, please check my website www.chompingchampion.com. The URL is given in the description box below. The recipe of this dish is also there in the description box below. I hope you have liked this video. If you have liked it, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel and click on the bell button to get all the notifications whenever we upload a video. That is on Wednesdays and Saturdays at 11 o'clock. Stay safe and stay fit. Bye till the next episode.